Andy, first of all, congratulations on making the Argentina squad. How does it feel to be called up for the first time?
Well, actually, the second time. as a dream come true.
As a young kid, I always
wanted to play for the national team. We got three good games to play now, preparing for the Copa America next year. I'm more than ready to play for the national team now. I'm getting more minutes, so the confidence is really high for me now. I'm delighted for the call up. I always want more.
Can you justify your decision to stay in the summer in your head? Do you think you would have got a call up say you didn't see the move on elsewhere?
Well, no one knows, to be honest. I stay because I believe in the nice work and because I love the club. And at the moment, it's a really good decision, to be honest. I'm working really hard, I'm very humble, we've got a really good squad, so hopefully I will reach my goals this season.
Andy, how important is this competition in terms of for you to get game time and put pressure on
level one? That's what I'm working for. Me and Brad, we work really hard. We're both talented goalkeepers, Matt as well, work really hard. And that's the best way for us. You always have to challenge everyone. Matt challenged me, I challenged Bern. Used to be the same with Pete and Douglas Pina. It's a big club, so challenges will always be there.
Is it hard, obviously, some people maybe not taking
Oh, I don't know. I think we're not talking serious about the Europa League. I think it's a great competition. It's European. It's on TV. Always, you can reach the Champions League if you win the Europa League. So I think it's really good competition. We take it really seriously always, and I'm really looking forward for the game tomorrow.
And what are the specifics of your goals this season? You just come back obviously from the road and ready, and you just talked about them then. What are your goals this season?
Like I said, since I signed for this club, my goal was always to be the number one. I've been here for almost 10 years already. I came as a young boy. Now I'm a grown man. I went on loan quite a few times, some good loans, some bad loans. But at the end of the day, my work ethic and commitment will always be the number one for Arsenal. And for the national team. That's the dream. Now, I said to my dad that I'm going to do it, and I won't stop until I'm the number one for Arsenal team.
Do you feel in your own mind that you are already the best goalkeeper at the club? Do you have to feel?
Yeah, of course. When I be the number one for Arsenal, you have to believe in yourself, no matter what. I believe in my talent, I believe in my work. I had the luck to have a really good goalkeeper coach. Gary Payton helped me a lot. Sal, Javi, they've taken it to another level, to be honest. I'm very grateful, but my goals are much higher than that.
Como dije recién, es un sueño para mí, es algo que
like
le prometí
said,
a mi padre
desde
que jugaba en la selección sub-15. Le prometí ese día que iba a ser el mejor arquero del sudamericano, lo hice. Después de convocé para la sub-17, la sub-20, fui una vez a la mayor, pero todavía me quedó esa sensación de que tenía que debutar en la mayor.
Y
trabajé 8 años durísimo. La última vez fue en el 2011. Me convocó Batista para 2 amistosos y no tuve la oportunidad de jugar. Me costó mucho, la verdad, son 7 años de sacrificio. Volver ahora es un paso más en mi carrera. Y quiere decir que estoy haciendo las cosas bien. Pero, como te dije, mis metas son mucho más de las que son ahora y lo voy a cumplir.
Importante que ayer en el Superclásico argentino no ocurriese nada grave fuera de las calles, solamente se limitase a lo que es el fútbol, ¿verdad?
Bueno, tuvieron la experiencia del año pasado, lo que pasó, y fue muy triste no que no se juegue una final de la Libertadores en Argentina y se ha sido en Madrid. Eso habló mal del país y es bueno que haya pasado esto. Creo que hay mucha más seguridad ahora en el fútbol argentino y espero que siga así.
Thank you very much.
No, thank you.